Dear all, good afternoon. Today I will discuss a topic, evaporation. Its definition, objective, and multiple effect evaporator. Definition: theoretically, evaporation means simply vaporization from the surface of the liquid. In another way, evaporation is an unit operation by which a solvent is evaporated from a solution by boiling the liquor in a suitable vessel and withdrawing the vapor, leaving a concentrated liquid residue. Now, the objective of evaporation is to make a solution more concentrated. Generally, extracts are concentrated in this way. Now, see multiple effect evaporator. In case of multiple effect evaporator, one or two or more evaporators are connected to each other. Minimum. So in this diagram, there are three evaporators which are connected to each other. In this case, feed is supplied into the first evaporator. Steam is also supplied into the first evaporator, and from the first effect evaporator, the vapor which is produced in first effect evaporator, that is used as a source of steam in case of second effect evaporator, and from the second effect evaporator, this vapor is used as a source of steam in case of third effect evaporator, and from first effect evaporator, the product which is coming out, a concentrated liquid which is coming out, that is used as a source of feed in the second effect evaporator. And from the second, it is used as a source of feed in third effect evaporator. And finally, from the last effect, we are collecting the product as a concentrated product. Simply, in a single effect evaporator, steam is supplied for heating the liquor. The total heat is not transferred from the steam, so the rest of the heat is wasted. To use that heat efficiently, connections are made so that vapor from one effect serves as the heating medium for the next effect. The dilute feed enters the first effect where it is partly concentrated. It flows to the second effect for additional concentration and then to the third effect for final concentration. This liquor is pumped out of the third effect. In first effect, raw steam is fed in which vapor pressure in the evaporator is the highest, which I have discussed in the previous slide. The pressure gradient is maintained by drawing the vapor through a vacuum pump and condensing after the final effect. Depending upon the lowering of vapor pressure, boiling point of liquids of second and third effect will also be lowered. That is, temperature in first effect is higher than in temperature in second effect than in third effect. In the second effect evaporator, from first effect T1 is the heating the liquor having temperature T2. So there is a temperature gradient, that is T1 minus T2. Consequently, the liquor will be heated. Similar heating will be there in third effect also. Then there are four methods of feeding in case of multiple effect evaporator. First one is forward feeding, backward feeding, mixed feeding, and lastly parallel feeding. Forward feeding. In case of forward feeding, the feed is entered into the first effect evaporator and finally the product is collected from the last effect evaporator. So the advantages of this forward feeding is feed moves from high pressure to low pressure chambers. So pumping of liquor is not required. And the second point is product is obtained at lowest temperature. This method is suitable for scale forming liquids because concentrated product is subjected to the lowest temperature. Now, disadvantages of this method is it is not suitable for cold feed because the steam input in effect 1 raises the temperature of the feed, and a small amount of heat is supplied as latent heat of vaporization. Therefore, amount of vapor produced will be less than the amount of steam supplied. So lower amount of vapor in the effect 1 produces lower amount of vapor in the subsequent effects. Therefore the overall economy is lower. Now the next one is backward feeding. In this case, the feed enters into the evaporator from the last effect, then to third, then to second, and then to first effect evaporator, and finally the product is obtained from the first effect evaporator. Whereas steam is supplied into the evaporator from the first effect, then to second, then to third, then to fourth effect. In the backward feed, the feed enters in the last effect and moves towards the first effect. Advantages of this method is it is suitable for cold feed because the heat used for increasing the temperature in fourth effect is already used in for heating three times, is already used for heating three times. So this will give more economy. Next advantage is this method is suitable for viscous products because highly concentrated product is at highest temperature, hence lower viscosity. Disadvantage of this method is liquid moves from low pressure to high pressure chambers, so pumping is required. Next method is mixed feeding. In case of mixed feed, the feed enters into the intermediate effect, moves forward and then backward to effect 1. So in this diagram, feed is entered into the third effect and then from third effect it is moving to fourth effect, and then from fourth to second and second to first effect. So advantage of this method is liquid moves from high pressure to low pressure, that is third to fourth, hence no pumping is required, and liquid moves from fourth to second to first, it requires pumping. Product is obtained at from highest temperature, that is from first effect evaporator, hence lowest viscosity. Now the last method is parallel feeding. Parallel feeding, in this method, feed is supplied in all the effects, first effect, second effect, third effect and fourth effect separately, and the product is also collected in the form of thick liquor from all the effect. That means it is suitable for the feed which has to be concentrated slightly. That means parallel feeding should be used in those cases where less concentrated liquid is necessary or less concentrated product is necessary. So friends, this is all about parallel feeding. That means evaporation, its objective, and multiple effect evaporator and its feeding arrangement. So I hope you have understand all these topics properly. Thank you.